उधर कर्नाटक के बेंगलुरु में 24 घंटों के दौरान मुख्तलिफ मकामात पर बड़े पैमाने पर एहतजाज हुआ है। शहरियत तरमीम कानून के खिलाफ जिस तरह का एहतजाज देखा गया था, वैसे ही एहतजाज अब वहां पर बेंगलुरु की सड़क पर देखा गया। गुज़िश्ता रोज बड़ी तादाद में ख़वातीन और तालिबात इस एहतजाज में शरीक हुई और उनका यही कहना था कि ये हमारा बुनियादी हक है और हम अपने हक के लिए एहतजाज कर रहे हैं। हिजाब पर पाबंदी लगाना मुनासिब नहीं है। बेंगलुरु में हुए इस एहतजाज में तालिबात की बड़ी तादाद थी और तालिबात का जो अज़्म देखा गया वो काबिले मुबारकबाद है।
है कि सेक्शन जो है सेक्शन जो है 15/1 आर्टिकल 15/3 इसके अगर अंदर हम देखेंगे, इसके साबित करता है कि हम जो है अपना हिजाब डालकर या जो भी ड्रेस कोड हमारा है हम वो पहन कर जो है हम अपना एजुकेशन हासिल कर सकते हैं। तो इसमें नुकसान क्या है? इससे पहले बहुत सारे जो है मुस्लिम लीडर्स जो हैं, लेडीज जो हैं, स्कॉलर्स बनी हैं, डॉक्टर्स बने हैं, मेडिकल फील्ड के अंदर हैं, इंजीनियर हैं, उन लोगों से किसी को नुकसान नहीं पहुंचा, तो आइंदा आने वाली पीढ़ी को कैसे नुकसान पहुंच रहा है? हम तो हिंदुस्तानी सभ्यता और कल्चर को फॉलो कर रहे हैं, तो इसमें क्या नुकसान है? बस यही हमारा ये है मुतालबा है कि हमको जो है इंसाफ मिलना चाहिए और सर ढांक कर चाहे हो हम यूनिफॉर्म फॉलो करते हैं, हम कोई अश्लीलता नहीं दिखा रहे, पूरे बदन को ढांक रहे हैं, पूरे जिस्म को ढांक रहे हैं, शरीर को ढांक रहे हैं और बस एजुकेशन हासिल करना चाह रहे हैं। अगर इसमें कोई नुकसान है तो वो हमारे सामने लेकर आए, बस इतना ही हमारा कहना है। हमको उस बारे में कोई बात नहीं करनी, इसको पॉलिटिकल रूल रंग दिया जा रहा है या क्या कर रहे हैं, हमारा बस ये है कि हमारी तकलीफ दूर करो और हिंदुस्तान के कानून को फॉलो करो, बस इतना ही हमारा कहना। मेरा नाम अफरोज जहां है।
टू आस्क अवर राइट, हिजाब इज अवर राइट, इट इज अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल राइट। सी इवन इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दे हैव गिवन अ फंडामेंटल राइट टू फॉलो एनी रिलीजन, दैट मींस वी कैन वेयर एनी ड्रेस कोड ऑल्सो, इजंट इट? But what we are doing here in the name of dress code in the school, we are just destroying the communal harmony here. What they are doing, they are creating a communal harmony here. Instead of giving interest for the students in the studies, students have been destroyed interest in the studies. They have been followed wearing different kinds of colors, this and all. Students are not wearing full burqa, right? They are just wearing hijab. Only hijab, scarf they are wearing. And even in their own institution, they have written in their own diary also, scarf has been allowed, any color scarf has been allowed. But why on the name of hijab in this state it's going on communal harmony? Just because political agenda is there, they are destroying this and they are creating hijab. In the name of hijab they are creating this communal harmony. Inshallah high court will also allow, because this is given in the amendment also, isn't it? It is given in the provision also, amendment also. It is a fundamental right, sir. It's something which we have it. We are not taking it, we already have it. It's a right. Before it was not affecting, just before few months before it was not affecting, but it is affecting now. Why? Because it has become a political agenda. Before it was not there. Before, from many years, even we studied wearing hijab only. Even we studied in a Christian missionary school, there also they didn't oppose us. Even Mother Teresa is also wearing scarf, isn't it? Even Ahilya Bai is also wearing scarf. Even in the Rajasthan, many women wear scarf. Even now also many women, maybe we can take religious women also, they are wearing scarf, they wear even dupatta pallu also. Even in competitions also nowadays, they are wearing pallu and they are dancing. Because it is an Indian tradition, right?
There's this other argument saying that it's a kind of a regressive practice that should be dropped and it should start.
Why it was not pointed out last year also? Last so many years also? Why it was not pointed out? It is pointed out now because it is a political agenda. That's it, I know.
Well, there you go.
Amreen. The reason for today's protest and the reason that we have all gathered here, these are not any special protest. These are normal citizens of India who are just these local people over here. They have come out because they are agitated, threatened, horrified, and it is traumatizing to see that the age-old tradition of hijab that Muslim women in this country are being following, it is being taken away by the government. Today it happened in some other place, it might happen in a different place. So we are threatened by the fact that government is imposing such rules which is discriminatory on the ground of religion, which is discriminatory on the grounds of education. Students of India are like deprived of the rights of education in the name of hijab. And that is why we are not in favor of the decision that is being made. And we are saddened by the situation that girls are being deprived of education and thrown out of their schools. And it is even more sadder that their own fellow students who should have been in favor of those, they have been protesting against that. We are saddened and threatened. We are seriously threatened by the policies that are being told,
and just because I mentioned I am threatened does not mean I will back down and keep quiet, because it is a cruel decision taken by the government, and we are still against it. All women are in solidarity with us for this protest, stating that we will never take such discriminatory. I will not give any comments of the political, because it is clear enough what is happening and what is not. People are just trying a blind eye to it. Thank you.